Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Please like, share, and subscribe. There was a magnitude 5.1 earthquake about 2:30 this afternoon near Potrerillos, Honduras. I've been trying to figure this one out because of the intensity ball here. The moment tensor ball shows that the, it's spreading. And it came straight up. Tension was applied. Going probably west. There in this location, Honduras, Guatemala, they have a lot of very destructive earthquakes because they're so shallow. And here's the location of the 5.1. Yeah, it's out there in the water, and it's in between two fault zones. This one right here, Mataga, is responsible for the 1976 7.5 earthquake. And then we got another one to the north, Palakic. Long time ago, during the time of the Mayans, Palakic had a series of earthquakes, that created a lot of devastation. It was a time of drought also. And they feared the earthquakes contributed to the downfall of the Mayan society. The tectonic setting of the Central American region is characterized by the interaction of three major plates, lithospheric plates. The Cocos Plate, which is down over here, the Caribbean, over here to the right, and the North American Plate, the top left. In this region, the relative plate motion is in the order of 2 to 9 centimeters a year and is accompanied by active volcanism and shallow intermediate seismicity. The Cocos Plate moves towards the north-northeast with respect to the Caribbean Plate, and the North American Plate, at a velocity of about 70 to 80 millimeters a year, and subducts beneath the Central American and Middle American Trench that I got drawn out here in orange. Back in 1976, the Mataga fault ruptured, slipped over about 155 miles. It was a left lateral rupture, or 250 kilometers. That was probably one of the most destructive earthquakes that they had in that area. It occurred on February 4th, 1976, causing 23,000 deaths and 77,200 injuries. The total number of homes destroyed was about 258,000, and about 1.2 million people were left homeless. Now, during that earthquake, there was evidently lateral spread in El Salvador. And maybe it answers some of the questions about the spreading from this 5.1 earthquake. There was also liquefaction. It's kind of strange to think about that because it was so far from the 1976 earthquake. That's where the ground turns to jello, quicksand. USGS gave it an intensity level of 4, and it was felt all the way down there by El Salvador. That area, they had one response, and they gave it an intensity level of 2. Looks like most of the felt reports were on the Caribbean side of the fault zone. So on the south side of this fault zone, that's where the earthquake occurred up there. Osman, I'm probably pronouncing it wrong. They did give it an intensity level 4. And Los Hermanos, intensity level 4 also. Again, on the southern side of the fault zone. So intensity level 4 means it was felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few. If they were resting or taking a nap, they would have been woken up dishes, windows, and doors disturbed, autos rock noticeably. So going back to Google Earth, yeah, this would probably be the location of the strongest felt reports. And like I said, it was up here off the shores of Honduras. There has been quite a few aftershocks. I got three different monitors that I downloaded. And let's open this one up and make this one bigger. You see one there, one there. Let me go there. We'll go to the spectrogram. And there. And then another one there. Another one there. And another one. Let's go to the seismic signature. Alright, there's one. Another one. And another one. And another one. Yeah, let me make this bigger. There you go. Yeah, you can see it's all tectonic in movement. Here's the stream view, and you can compare them across all three monitors there. Yeah, and then we'll go back another 4 hours, because that's where the earthquake came in. And then you can see there was one aftershock. People are saying they did feel it. And then another aftershock right there. Maybe they'll give you a better image of the aftershocks that are occurring afterwards. Yeah, I just hope they don't have a large one there. It's like, oh my goodness. Yeah, I find it interesting. Anyways, what are your thoughts? Sending prayers to everybody. Please put that information down below if you did feel it. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.